In Bamban, Tarlac, Rodolfo Salas is renewing his ties with his Aita community. Fisher Farm through Karudi will help them grow fruit trees and raise goats for their livelihood. The company will also provide them training and scholarships. The original cooperative Aita Magansi, which Salas organized 10 years ago from 150 families of the Magansi tribe, was engaged in landscaping jobs for Clark Development Corporation. But after 4 years, CDC awarded contracts to other firms. Now Salas is speaking to the tribe's elders to help them get on their feet again. Some can even work in Fisher Farm's processing plant. The head of the cooperative is Manuel De Vera. Kamichi and Karudi have been friends since the NPA days.
So ito yung mga gusto nyo pang gawin in the future. So marami pa kayong plano.
Makapagtayo doon ng technical school for the Aita. Kasi sa kanila hanggang elementary lang eh. Para makapag-aral ng high school po, punta pa doon sa bayan. I think busy ako naman coming years pa.
The former NPA head has also become more pragmatic in viewing the world that has changed drastically since his days in the underground. He is not joining the chorus of militant groups against the prospect of increased U.S. military presence in the Philippines.
Hindi lang sa Pilipinas yung nagkaroon ng pagbabago, kundi all over the world, no? Na una na yung economies ng ibang countries ay interlinked na, no?
So would you welcome the U.S. increased military presence?
Ano yun, no? Okay lang. Basta yung ano yun, nakakatulong sa pagdepensa sa Pilipino.
How would you assess yung, sabi nyo, the same problems remain even if there's, you know, increased democratic space? Anong assessment nyo sa sitwasyon?
Ano eh, yung, mula yung siguro, una nga grabe talaga yung sitwasyon ng politika. Kung wala kang pera, even tumakbong konsyala ng bayan, hindi ka makakatak. So yung mga necessary ano ng isang democratic process, wala. Para talaga mabigyan ng parang equal opportunity.
So you're saying wala masyadong asenso?
May asenso makita mo. Daan, ganyan. No? Mga daan, mga bahay, pero malalagay mo dun ang asenso na dun sa mga 10% lang, nung, the upper 10%. O sabihin mo na 20% of ng population. Pero yung the large majority, yung kalagayan nila yung dati pa rin.
But he also laughs off the possibility of seeking public office like his former comrades in the left.
Di sabi niyo, because of the declaration of FBR, burado lahat, so you can run for public office.
Yes, so...
But hindi niyo inisip
niyo. No, I'm tired of running.
Do you still carry a gun?
Meron pa rin akong baril. Pero hindi ako na dinada. Depends sa lugar.
Pero yung baril niyo, natago niyo ba? Yung
hindi, license. Ako, license.
Yung mga NPA, wala na?
Hindi, meron pa, meron pa rin mga natago nandyan, siyempre.
Nakabaon sa lupa?
Mga... May naka-safety. Oh, siyempre, hindi mo pa rin talaga 100% na no, ano yung mangyayari, di ba?
This time, the ex-commander is having a second chance too at leading a normal life, starting a new family with Joanna, his companion for 5 years now, with whom he has 2 children, 3-year-old John Rudes and 1-year-old Jamea.
How should we refer to you? An ex-revolutionary or still a, you know, a revolutionary? How would you characterize yourself now?
As of now, through peaceful means, no?
As of now, meron kayong qualifier.
Kasi nga, yung means na ng ano eh, yung means of struggle, depende naman sa political situation yun eh. Siyempre, ang gata, no, lalo na ngayon, ang mas importante pa yung re-educating the, ano, the people, no? And then, open pa yung venues for legal, ano, legal means, no? Kumbaga, sa, no, yung